A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18 December, on the front page you have 21 hurt as protesters clash with police in Delhi. So anti-citizenship amendment act agitations took a violent turn in various regions. You can see two police booths were set on fire, two police bikes were damaged. This is in Silampur in Delhi. And here you have no special UNSC meet on Kashmir. So a special meeting of permanent members of UN Security Council on Kashmir was not convened as scheduled on Tuesday. This is what diplomatic sources have confirmed. So this meeting was sought by China actually to discuss India's decision to end the special status of Jammu and Kashmir. So China is actually is concerned because it also has a stake in Jammu and Kashmir. We have seen how China has acquired territory. It has also leased out territory from Pakistan in Jammu and Kashmir. Then below you have Musharraf sentenced to death for high treason. So a special court in Pakistan has awarded death sentence to former dictator General Pervez Musharraf for committing high treason. So he seized power through a military coup in 1999 and was found guilty of high treason under Article 6 of the Constitution for imposing emergency in 2007. He is presently in Dubai. So he says he has been victimized. And this is packaged food breached salt and fat limits. Several packaged foods, it is seen, they breached the limit for salt and fat content. This is an analysis conducted by Center for Science and Environment, CSE. On page 8, you have Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister hints at three capitals for state. So, South African model, which has three capitals. So, you should know South Africa has three capitals. One is judicial capital, legislative capital, and the government seat, the executive capital. So, such model is most viable, is what Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister YS Jagan Mohan Reddy says. So, he says balanced development is the goal. So we have seen of Andhra Pradesh, one capital which has been developed is Amravati. And then you can see Vishakhapatnam also lies in Andhra Pradesh. Kurnool also, he says, can be considered for judicial capital. So Amravati is the legislative capital, Kurnool as judicial capital, and Vishakhapatnam, as which has the infrastructure, as the executive capital. And this is advisory to Gujarat, or advisory for Gujarat model kicks up a row. So Union Health Ministry has called for non-interventional approach during final stage of labor. So at a time when obstetricians are fighting to bring down the incidence of postpartum hemorrhage, which is the leading cause of maternal mortality in India, a recent advisory issued by Union Health Ministry to states to adopt the Gujarat model of non-interventional approach during the final stage of labor is the best obstetric practice has kicked up a storm. So obstetricians are advised, say the advisory is contrary to World Health Organization recommendations and the best proven international advisories. And they say that this can undo all their efforts to reduce postpartum hemorrhage and prevent mothers bleeding to death. On page 9, you have defense ties to get push at 2+2 with US. So this is regarding US-India 2+2 dialogue, where two prominent leaders from India, that is Defense Minister and External Affairs Minister, meet their counterparts from USA. So this External Affairs Minister is Jay Shankar and Defense Minister Rajnath Singh, they would meet Pompeo and Esper. So there'll be more detail even after the meet takes place, but important issues are covered like Comcasa, which Communications Compatibility and Security Agreement. So this has been signed during the previous 2+2 dialogue. But discussions on the last foundational agreement, that is BECA. So we have already signed one. And you know, LEMOA, then COMCASA, then BECA, and Industrial Security Annex. So this may be signed now. BECA is the last one which has not been concluded yet. So, so there are still differences on BECA, that is Basic Exchange of Cooperation Agreement for Geospatial Cooperation. So this is then there's Quad grouping, which comprises of four nations in the Indo-Pacific region, that is India, Australia, Japan, and USA. So this quad grouping will also be discussed. It is also considered, quad is also considered to be a counter to China in Indo-Pacific, but quad members say no. And even then below you have, government aims to provide broadband access to all villages by 2022. So this is a new mission which has been announced to provide broadband access to all villages by 2022, which entails an investment of 7 lakh crore from various stakeholders. So national broadband mission. So this is for universal and equitable access of broadband services across the country. So this is there. So the investment, you can see 7 lakh crore. So out of this, 70,000 crore will come from USOF, Universal Service Obligation Fund. So we know already about USOF, which is for which is actually 5% of the turnover of telecom companies, which is submitted by them, which is, you know, this is a contribution from them, which is to be used for rural broadband connectivity, rural connectivity, actually telecom connectivity. And this is UIDAI drops monitoring agency plan. So UIDAI, that is the apex body for Aadhaar. So it has informed the Supreme Court about its decision to withdraw its proposal to hire a social media monitoring agency. So this was their plan earlier, that a social media monitoring agency will be employed, will employ online reputation management and social listening tools to monitor and influence conversations on Aadhaar on Facebook and Twitter. So it has dropped this idea now. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is the general in trouble. So this is regarding the front page news. Musharraf, former dictator of Pakistan, he has been sentenced to death. So it says the judiciary in Pakistan is providing an opportunity to redraw civil military relations. This is the earlier also we had seen how it had created an issue on reappointment of military chief. Even Parvez Musharraf was a former military chief of Pakistan. Then this is justice for Rohingya. So this is regarding how Myanmar must guarantee immediate protection for its Muslim minority. The case hearing also took place in International Court of Justice. The lead article, Time to Defend India's Secularism. So this is regarding Citizenship Amendment Act and the protests taking place against it. So the article says that this is written by Kerala Chief Minister. So it says that this act has imperiled the nation's constitutional values and no one can afford to be silent. So it affects the social fabric of the country and secularism of the country, and it's not just Muslims which need to protest, but everyone has to raise their voice, because it is true that it's not going to affect Indian Muslims, but it is discriminating on the basis of religion. Then this is bearing the brunt of slack laws. So this is regarding labor laws are being modified. So the tweaking of labor laws on safety and minimum wage has left a large section of workers in India without rights. So this is a critique on the labor codes. That's very important. Then on the op-ed page, you have left to the whims of the executive. So this is regarding the Citizenship Act. So it is a mere skeleton. The flesh and blood is left to be dictated by executive action. So this is much more dangerous. So this is again a critique on Citizenship Amendment Act. And this is fish in troubled waters. So this article says that India needs studies on the threat posed by invasive alien species to ecosystems and the policy to address the problem. So when alien species means species not of the particular region, they enter into a particular ecosystem, a particular region, then they become invasive too. That is invasive in the sense they eat up and dominate the ecosystem. So local species are significantly affected. Drastically affected, adversely affected, you can say. So studies are needed on threat posed by these invasive alien species. And this is in pursuit of structural reforms. So this article says that economic freedom should become the guiding principle of nation's policy making. So how structural reforms have to be brought in. So that is detailed out here. Means free from government control. So that's the idea. Then on international page, you have this coverage on the same front page news regarding Musharraf's death sentence. So army says that Musharraf can never be a traitor. And this is a news analysis on this death sentence. What does it mean? Because he is not going to be directly affected. He is not in Pakistan. And this is US firms sued for death of children in Democratic Republic of Congo. So five US tech giants, including Apple, Microsoft, and Google parent Alphabet, have been named in a lawsuit over the death of a child or death of child laborers in cobalt mines in the Democratic Republic of Congo. So this is impoverished but mineral rich country. It's the world's largest producer of the rare metal, that is cobalt, which is crucial for making batteries used in mobile phones and electric vehicles. So a case has been lodged in the name of these 14 unidentified victims who are members of the families of children killed in tunnel collapses, as well as children maimed as they worked. Then on business page you have telecom body defers zero IUC by a year. So this is regarding interconnection usage charges. So telecom regulator, that is TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, wanted to implement the zero interconnect usage charges from 2020. So it means from 1st Jan 2020, but this has been deferred for a year, means it will now come into effect from 1st January 2021. So stakeholders' views were taken on fixing minimum tariff for mobile voice calls and data services too. So the floor price has been demanded by telecom companies themselves. So telecom regulator TRAI is looking into that matter too. So that is it. These are the important headlines. Last page has sports related news. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com. Thank you.